How a young man in a far-off land went from zero to hero is the story our Steve Hartman has to tell.
No one likes internet scammers, but here in Ogden, Utah, we found a guy with a most profound distaste. I mean, just wait till you hear how 34-year-old Ben Taylor responded to one random message, which read, "My name is Joel from Liberia, West Africa. I need some assistance from you, business or financial assistance that will help empower me." To which Ben insincerely responded, "How can I help?"
You didn't mean that.
Well, I wanted to see, how does this whole scam operation work, and how do they bait people? And
so you're just curious.
I just wanted to go down this rabbit hole and see, what were the tricks that they used to get people?
And there's no way you could have guessed where that rabbit hole was going to go.
There's no way I could have guessed.
The journey began when Joel in Africa proposed a business partnership. He asked Ben to mail used electronics to some place in New Jersey. Supposedly, the electronics would be resold and the profits split.
I looked it up on Google Earth. It was just in a sketchy part of town. There were broken down cars all over the place.
Street View even had a cop checking out the joint. Still, Joel insisted he would never take advantage of someone. Bible says in Proverbs 22, "A good name is better than silver and gold," Joel wrote. Of course, Ben didn't buy a word of it, so he proposed a different partnership. He lied to Joel, told him he owned a photography business and could use some pretty pictures.
"So how about a sunset? How about a nice Liberian sunset?"
And what, you were gonna pay him for the pictures of the sunset?
Yeah, I said, "That's good, if I like it, sure."
You're just trying to keep him busy so he doesn't rip off somebody else.
I figured the more time of theirs that I could waste, the less time that they'd have to spend ripping me or other people off.
Eventually, Joel sent two sunset photos, we think.
I think there's a sun somewhere in there.
Turns out scenic photography
could be
wasn't exactly Joel's strong suit.
That could be a pupil.
Not that it mattered.
I told him, "Hey, this is great."
Oh, you told him this is great?
I said, "This is a good job, but I think you need a little bit better of a camera."
So Ben actually spent $60 to buy and mail him this shiny red one.
Now this has gone beyond wasting his time.
Yeah.
Now you're wasting your time.
Yeah, so I'm investing my money. My family thinks I'm crazy because I'm interacting with this guy in Liberia.
But Joel didn't think it was crazy at all. He wrote, "I've decided to really commit and devote myself to this business. What other pictures you want me to take?" Ben replied, "We've got to work on your photography." And eventually, Joel did get better.
Yeah, these are actually pretty good.
Which posed a big problem.
When he put in the work, I thought, oh no, now I've got to figure out a way to compensate Joel for these pictures, or I'm going to be the scammer.
Well, the final copies are in. And
so Ben took to YouTube to sell a booklet he made using the pictures. He called it "By the Grace of God," a phrase borrowed from Joel's messages. The plan was to sell a few dozen copies to friends and family until sales exploded.
People from around the world in places that I never even heard of were buying Joel's book.
Soon they raised $1,000. Ben told Joel he could have half, and the rest, well, Joel would get that too, but with a catch. Ben told him he had to donate that $500 to charity. And so, with that intention in mind, Ben wired the money.
At this point, you need to know, $500 is like a year's salary in Liberia. So really, it's kind of ridiculous to expect an unemployed, impoverished hustler to just give all that money away. In fact is, Ben never thought he would. Until another batch of pictures arrived.
There were book bags, notebooks. He cleaned out the market, rented a cab to haul the loot, and blessed five schools with abundance. Joel, seen here with a crown inadvertently overhead, turned out to be more savior than scammer.
He came through.
You were wrong about him.
He showed me that there was a different side to him.
For Ben, it was such a revelation.
And so here we are.
He did something he could have never imagined just a few months earlier. He traveled to Monrovia, Liberia, set aside his doubt and distrust, and opened his mind to the very real possibility that someone he thought was a bitter enemy might actually be a friend in disguise.
Joel, yeah. How you doing, man?
Yeah.
It's good to see you.
I've been to see you.
First thing Ben learned was that Joel never saw himself as a scammer.
Yeah.
Joel saw his trolling more like a friend search.
Were you looking for a friend, or were you looking for somebody to give you some money?
The person got to be my friend before, you know.
I'll give you some money.
And before they can give me some money, yeah.
So
yeah.
Somehow you found Ben on this phone?
This is how.
On that old dinosaur.
You got Facebook on there.
Yeah.
Joel used to send Facebook messages to strangers, hoping to find some way, someone to help him out of poverty.
How desperate were you?
Oh, I'm more than desperate, Steve, because I'm a family. I'm a father of seven. To feed the kids, a lot of things that run into your mind.
Like what?
Maybe you go and do this, the wrong thing.
There it is.
Fortunately, by the grace of God,
there's the book.
It never came to that.
There's the book that made it all happen.
They've now sold nearly 6,000 copies, which means this unlikely pair must now come up with a plan for their publishing enterprise. Some of the profits will go toward Joel's basic needs, like keeping rain out.
Brand new roof.
That looks good, man.
Yeah, yeah.
But they decided most of the money should be reinvested in the community. Liberia is one of the poorest nations in the world. Half the country survives on less than $2 a day. And because need is everywhere, Ben and Joel want to continue helping the most vulnerable. These are the children who got those school supplies.
Hello.
They would like to do more for them.
We appreciate that so much, thank you.
Oh, Joel had to do a lot of work to make it happen.
They're also granting microloans to young entrepreneurs in Joel's neighborhood.
You're gonna keep helping them, right?
And hope to do a whole lot more.
I wanna come back.
Because Ben is no longer the cynic who started all this.
That's just not me. I've changed. I set out to embarrass a guy. I ended up helping a guy. I would much rather continue to help people. You feel good when you help others.
And as for Joel, he says he's changed too.
Bedroom.
Although he still has to support his wife and seven kids on what most of us spend at Starbucks.
They share this area here?
Yeah.
Joel says he's okay using much of the money to help others.
I help other people.
In fact, he says the opportunity to be charitable may be the best thing to come from this.
I need to receive.
Mm-hmm. Now you're the giver.
I'm giving now. Yeah.
At one point,
yeah,
he sent you $500.
Yeah.
And he told you to spend the money not on yourself,
mm-hmm,
but on others.
Yes.
Why didn't you keep that money?
It's stealing. And I'd be dishonest. When you are truthful, when you are honest, sometimes from nobody, you can be somebody. From zero to be a hero. I have come from zero to a hero.
Just because a person is poor doesn't mean they're not rich in character. In fact, many are great humanitarians, just waiting on the means.